Hey, Sushan, what's going on? I don't know what this video's about, but it was recommended I watch it, and it's got a lot of books that I have on my shelf. And I noticed this guy's books are destroyed. Like, what did you do? Anyway, so I've got this book here, and I got this book here. This is my favorite one. I got this yellow one here. Do I have the red one? Oh, do I have this one? I might have this one too. I have this one here, the human figure. I got this animation one thing. Animator's workbook, I got that. This one, I've got this one. I don't know if I have this edition. I might have a newer edition than this one. I got this one, Atlas of Human Anatomy for the Artist. I have as many books as he does, but not the same books. Does that make sense? If he showed 20 books, 18 books, I have that many art books on my shelf. Let's see here. Infinite Surface Podcast, Fat Stacks, Book Reviews with Jesse Thompson. Okay.
Welcome to the Infinite Surface Podcast. I'm Jesse Thompson, and this is Fat Stacks. And today, we're going over How to Draw Noir Comics by Sean Martinborough.
Ooh, do I have that book? Ay, 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 ay. I might have the PDF of that one.
Now, I'm really excited to go over this book because it's the second in our How to Draw Comics series. We looked earlier in another video at...
Of course, everyone has... I probably have 3 or 4 copies of this book. Now, that's a book I've destroyed because I've had it since, I don't know, 4th grade. So, of course, a 4th grader is going to bang up their books. You can still buy it at Barnes & Noble. It's in the anime section.
How to Draw Comics the Marvel Way by Stan Lee and John Buscema. And I talked about this and its main virtue as being basically a basic drawing book with the subject matter of superheroes. And I think that's really a strength of this book. The same goes for this book. This is basically a composition design book that has the subject of comics and maybe more specifically noir comics. I think it's really strong for that. With the exception of Arthur Guptill's book, I think it's one of the strongest books on composition design.
Here's the big secret about women. We want you to flirt with us. We even want you to get sexual with us. Desire.
It starts out pretty typically. It has the format of How to Draw Comics the Marvel Way, at least to start. It starts out with a nice foreword and a preface.
We usually have camera angles. This one has lighting, shading, obviously.
And gets right into tools of the trade. And so this sort of dates the book as well. It was published.
I don't use those anymore. It's all ink pens now. I don't know anyone who still does ink this way, except for maybe my brother might do ink this way. I gave away all of my quills. I gave them all away to somebody who thought they were cool and they wanted to do calligraphy. I'm like, here, have it, take it.
In the digital age, but it doesn't talk about digital processes. It talks about traditional ink, crow quill pens, ink wells, things like that. So that's the same as what we would see in How to Draw Comics the Marvel Way.
Yeah, I use technical pens now. Yep, and I haven't had a brush. I haven't had any brushes in 40 years. When I got my first computer that could do graphics, the paintbrushes went bye-bye.
Nothing really too new there, maybe with the exception of some of these more recently made pens that weren't around during the How to Draw Comics the Marvel Way years. So then we get right into what Sean Martinborough calls the basics. And what he means by that, to start off, is to how to gather reference, right? Are you working from life or are you working from photography?
Working from black and white. Not just any old black and white, a certain kind of black and white.
Photography. And he wants to talk about how to stylize that, how to remove yourself from photographic reference or from working from observation. And this is really important. And he starts to talk about line work and brush stroke. And he especially mentions dry brush and adding texture. And this is what Sean Martinborough is really, really good at, is varying these kind of approaches where we see very, very thin lines like this, and then we see really thicker lines like this that are broken. So not every line has the same quality, and they start to suggest different things. They start to feel like almost different styles of drawing within one drawing, and I think that that's really effective. And these little breakdowns that give you options about how to lay out a drawing, I think, are really interesting. So he starts talking about creating mood with shadow and light. And this, of course, is essential to the idea of noir, right? And we start to get into these comparisons that he does. And this is really the power of this book. This is where I think that this book gets really, really great, where he starts to ask this question, well, which one of these drawings do you like better? And he's not trying to suggest that either one of them is better than the other one, but that they have different strengths and different weaknesses. And I think it's really useful for anybody who's learning to draw to, with their own opinions, come and look at these two drawings and say, well, which one do I like more? And so he starts to talk about composition design and big, bold shapes and how to add texture and interest into certain areas. And then he gets to really the strongest part of the book, which is these layouts, where he describes not only his process, but his thought process about how to juxtapose what we call reversals, which is to say how you reverse a white, a black, and a gray, or a light, a dark, and a gray. And so you see that here, white, black, 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 right? So here he's talking about how to incorporate details like these things like pinstripes, which creates basically a gray, right? So this would be a dark gray and this would be a light gray. And so he asked that question. You can see here in this moment, he starts to fade out some of his line work in there so that it becomes a white, so we get better contrast over here. And it's really interesting because we have these big dark shapes. You can see that earlier in the book, Sean Martinborough mentions that his favorite color is black and that he loves these big black shapes. And that's such an important part of composition, is compositional blacks. That's what we call it. And so what he's talking about here is juxtaposing these big black shapes with composition design. And so you can see in a moment like this that there's no line, there's no single line that separates this shape from that shape, or the ear, for instance. This black mark is the ear, and there's no line that goes around it. However, there are moments in Sean Martinborough's design where he does decide that he needs a line. Like, this is a good example where I guess he felt that the gray of the background with these pinstripes wasn't enough to separate the mass of this white head from the background. So he added this big dark black to separate the border. And you could even call this line the same thing. You can call that a line, or you can call that form drawing. But these are really, really great examples. And here he asks you to do the same thing, which is to make a line drawing. And without judgment, go the extra step to designing it with full contrast like this. And in order to do so, he says, well, you know, you have to lose some information here, yep, right? You have to be willing to forego this information.
Yep.
And you have to be willing to let it just be a compositional black for the power of the drawing. And you have to be able to let go of lines like this and allow just the perspective angles to describe that shape.
Yeah, some people are tempted to put a white line right here. Or to still leave little white lines for windows here. But with noir, you want it to be black. Just black, 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 you know. Like Batman Year One, I think, did it that way.
And he just asks a simple question, which is like, which do you like better? Because there's not really a great argument that says that this is better than this. It's just that they have different powers. They have different effects. And this, I think, is such a great, great, great page, because I think that students often get stuck in this part because it's quite risky to go to this part. You have to go and black out.
Yeah, because, yeah, noir, film noir is about shadows. I don't know why. I don't remember where it started. If it was Citizen Kane or before that. But in the late 40s and early 50s, oh man, it was everywhere.
A bunch of areas, and you have to lose all this drawing that you did. And so it feels a little bit scary to go this far. But you can see that it might be worth it. So he's suggesting here that you want to make a photocopy of a drawing like this and just ink it in and just see the power of that style of drawing and that way of adding compositional blacks. And then add that to your repertoire so that you're not afraid of being able to design like that. And here are some examples in subject matter rather than in composition. So here's a great example of combining those concepts, right? Where we have a line work drawing basically in the back and strong compositional black drawing in the foreground. Very moody, very lovely. Here's a great little comparison where we have detail within the shadow on the right without detail on the left. You can ask yourself which you like more.
Yeah, Patrick Nagel, he almost did this, almost. He was a two-tone guy, you know, the girls with the white faces, black hair. And, I don't know, he died soon after that, so I don't know. If he were alive, like, maybe 10 years longer, he probably would have been doing this kind of stuff with his paintings.
Here's an easy thing you can do to add to your routine so that you age better.
Age better.
Maybe better yet.
Stop age.
And I love these comparisons. I really do. I think it's such a great virtue of this book. As we go through the rest, it's going through the process of making a comic, designing characters. He talks about character design, texture, and shape design. He talks about location. He talks about making the graphic novel through storytelling and page layout. And here, of course, with page layout, we get back to composition design. He talks about thumbnail sketching. And this, of course, would be the preliminary step to that sequence that we saw earlier.
Storybooks.
Of designing the page, designing the panel.
Storyboards.
And here he's talking about specific panel design, panel size. All of just the details of making a comic. So as we go through,
the main thing when you're doing shadows on people's faces, never...
I feel like there's a lot of...
Let's see if I can find one here. You never want to do Hitler. See, is there a face, a dark face? Because if you're looking at photos, sometimes you'll see someone's face and the light. Okay, this one, the light's coming upwards. But oftentimes you have a photograph of someone in the dark and there's a light on their face from above. And the shadow of their nose, the shadow from their nose above their lip, you don't want to draw that in. Never, ever, ever, ever draw that in. Like here, see? If you're going to have the shadow under the nose, just do half under the nose. Never have the black shadow on the... Because then you end up with a Hitler mustache. You don't ever want a Hitler mustache. I don't know if books even mention that anymore. But in the 80s, that was kind of a big deal.
Eyes. All of just the details of making a comic. So as we go through,
see, like here's the shadow stops right there. It doesn't come straight down to his mouth. It's just little shading under the nose there. Here, there's no shading under the nose. It's just something you just don't do. For reasons. I've seen this guy's artwork before, I think. I wonder if I've ever read one of his comic books.
This information in many books, but I feel like the way in which Sean Martinborough goes into detail about it as it relates to composition is really one of the best books around for that. It's really one of the best sources for this kind of information. And the examples are just spot on. They're just perfect.
Yep.
Later, when we look at Arthur Guptill's book in another video, we'll see other examples of such things. But this Arthur Guptill's book is focused more on fine arts and illustration, whereas this is focused on noir comics. Another really nice part about this book is that as we get to the end, we actually see a comic that Sean Martinborough himself wrote and drew. And so he published his own little comic at the end of this so that you can see all of his concepts in action. And that's a really beautiful thing.
That's neat.
So that is it for my review of Sean Martinborough's How to Draw Noir Comics. Really recommend the book, especially to take that next step from draftsmanship and drawing subject matter to designing full compositions